What's up, everybody?
Good lord.
Sound like a loser. What's going on, everybody? My name is Wayne Howe. One of the questions I get a lot is, if I'm trying to get into video, if I'm trying to make better videos, what kind of camera do I need? What camera is going to make my videos spot on and are at a good price point? I know when I was first starting off, I tried a Nikon D5500, which is great for photos, a GoPro, all these different things. And what I was finding was, is there's a learning curve to every kind of camera that you buy. And the more you use a camera, the better it's going to come out and the more you're going to like the footage that you get. And the better you're gonna be able to storytell with that camera. I also realized that it doesn't really matter what camera or recording device you have if your story sucks. If your story sucks, nobody's gonna watch it anyways. So content over quality is key. Don't get me wrong, we're so used to seeing 1080p, we're so used to seeing things on our smartphones that are pretty decent quality. We become adapted to good quality images so our eyes pick up when something's not in the same playing field, there's a little lower quality. So you do want to have something that's a little modern, but to be honest, the best camera that you have to start off with, and you've been using it forever, and you have it right in your pocket, is your good old iPhone or smartphone. Your phone's camera is extraordinary for the size, how compact it is. It's putting out a pretty decent image that is acceptable on a lot of platforms, especially if you have something like Adobe or any kind of editing software. And there's a lot of these softwares you can get on your phone that can take your images to the next level if you're trying to get to that point. But for just pointing and shooting and creating a story, your iPhone takes great footage. One of the only issues I have with anything that's handheld like this, whether it be a GoPro, a DSLR, or your iPhone, is that there's a lot of camera shake when you're recording it. So you don't see it until you get into Premiere, but your camera will be shaky. It kind of takes away from the image. So if you have a smartphone, my top suggestion if you want to get into making videos is to invest in a gimbal. This is the gimbal I use. There's a newer version out now, thanks to DJI Osmo Mobile 2. I have the Osmo Mobile, which unfortunately is a little bit more expensive and not as good as the second one. This one was around $170. The new one is around $120. So they've dropped down in price, they increased in quality. What this is gonna allow you to do is stabilize your phone while you're taking footage. Let me show you what I mean. This is the DJI Osmo Mobile, and this is my cell phone. You have an adjustable gripper, whatever you wanna call it on this thing, that you can literally slide your phone into, whether it be a Samsung, iPhone, whatever size it is. You tighten this bad boy up on the back. You come over here, and it looks pretty smooth right now. You turn it on, and it automatically keeps your camera steady while you're moving it. With this button right here, you can even start to pan. You can go down, you can go up, all while you're moving the camera. You can even take your vlog on this. You can, anything you want to do, this is going to take your footage to the next level for about $170. That's a pretty decent entry point. You don't need this with your cell phone, but it definitely makes a big difference. My videos, while I'm still learning and getting better myself, at least the quality and the stability of my images have definitely gotten better because of this. I have recommended this gimbal to so many people solely because it's just helped me out so much. So I went and shot some footage of the DJI just to show you what it can do to your images and how fluid it can make a move and just the stability that it increases. So let's take a jump to that video so I can show you what I'm talking about. Disclaimer, I do move around a lot in my videos, and another disclaimer, I'm still learning as well. So my videos aren't, you know, Peter McKinnon's or they aren't Steven Spielberg, but for the average shooter, this is a great investment. And you'll be able to see that hopefully in the videos that I show you. Let's jump to that video now. Never knowing someone coming, try to take my life. I'll be sleeping with the 45 like every night. In the whip, I pray to God I don't see flashing lights. God damn, they right behind me. I wake up every day with the same.
don't see you, I'm watching, yeah. When people wanna be, you don't trust no one. Tell me why I can't get no relief. Wondering when they'll come for me.
So as you can see, while some of the images are still shaky because honestly, I still kind of suck, this makes a big difference. If you went and saw those images without the DJI gimbal and you were walking around, had a lot of movement going on, trying to follow a subject, you would see a lot of shake in your images. Maybe not. You can definitely get around using this. You can definitely go out there and be stable and make sure that everything's propped up right. I'm a firm believer that you don't need good equipment to be good. It's really just about you and the effort you're putting in. And the equipment is nice and it helps, and we've gotten a lot into tech and just that in general. But at the end of the day, it's all about the story you're telling, the effort that you're willing to put in. If you're willing to go out there and make sure that you're holding your handheld camera completely steady and that you are 100% making sure there's no camera shake, you might not need this. But this does make life a lot easier, and it also makes shooting video a little bit more fun. So my recommendation, while it might not be the sexiest or go buy a $1,000 camera and it'll dramatically make your films better, is to focus on your storytelling and to just get out there and shoot. Find out if you actually enjoy shooting. You'll learn a lot by just getting out there and doing it. You're not gonna learn a lot by buying a bunch of equipment and occasionally shooting videos. So if you use a gimbal or you shoot on your cell phone, which is becoming more popular, comment below and let me know what you like and what you don't like about it. I'm gonna include a link to this gimbal and the newer version of this gimbal that's cheaper in the description below. So go check it out, see if it's in your price range, see if it's something that you would like to invest in. And I'm just starting out, so if you would hit that subscribe button, and I'll be posting videos on photography, videography, I'll be vlogging, and I'll just be giving you honest insights on what I'm learning, because I still am new, and maybe share them with you. And we can just create a community where we all get better and improve and help each other out. So hit that subscribe button. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And as always, stay creative.